Today we'll be talking about amplifiers and speaker processor.
Like, what is an amplifier basically?
An amplifier is just a device that helps to boost an incoming signal. The volume has to do with height, it has to do with distance, but when you say sensitivity has to do with width, clarity, audibility, and impedance. Impedance has to do with resistance, that is how much of the 1000 watts is it letting out. DSP, digital speaker processor. You get it? Sure, you get it. I'll be talking about equalization. I'll be talking about filters. I'll be talking about crossover, and I'm talking about limiters. These four things are the things I'm going to talk about. The first one is equalization. Now, when a tailor wants to design a cloth, the first thing she does is to cut the material according to the design of what she wants to do. She will not be sewing before she cuts. She must first cut before she sews. So when she cuts, she cuts the pattern, she cuts what she needs. So that is what an equalizer does. An equalizer is a tool that is used to shape the sound of a speaker in response to the hall. Because you move from hall A to hall B to hall C, when you're carrying your speakers, you have different, the room will respond differently. Like when you go to a room that has a lot of echo, it will respond differently to a room that has less echo. That is the term that they understand. It's echo, they call it. We call it room response, but let's use the term that generally people understand. So all these things, they respond differently. So you have to, in the equalizers, to retune, to make these things ready for the room, so that the room will not be fighting with the speaker. We want the speaker and the room to be like husband and wife. Like. When the EQ is now right, that is when they now push the ring in their finger, like, oh yes, we have, no, this is what I did, not the other one, this is what I did, like the ring, not the other finger, I don't do that. So, when you put the ring in, that means the speaker and the hall has connected, they've synchronized, so they can work well and stuff. So that is just what I want you to understand about. That is the way I can explain it for you to get. If I start talking about the frequency, you might be lost. So just see it as that. Equalizer is a pencil and an eraser. You can add to something or remove from something. That is equalizer. Now crossover. Now, you know, when we want to prepare food, when you have maybe your gari, your rice, your food, whatever, and you have different type of sieves. You know sieves, now what we used to remove some dead particles from food. So we have different sieves. We have some sieves that have very wide openings. Some of them have tiny openings. Some of them have tiny.
Some of them have very tiny.
Very big opening. What am I trying to say is that filters are like what you use to determine how much of this thing you want is to go, how much of this thing you don't want it to go. In fact, crossover is all about filters. Now, when you say crossover, you know, imagine this, you have 10 people sitting around, you want to snap pictures, you have tall people, you have short people, you have medium-sized people, and you want to take a picture, and you put a tall person in front of a short person. Abba, biko why na, amaka why, don't do that. You have covered the destiny of that person, you have made that person to not exist now. Abba. Chill out now. So what am I trying to say here is that you put a small person, the shortest person, you put him in the front. You put a medium-sized person at the back of a short person, and you put the tall person at the back of the medium-sized person. So it's going to go like this: 1, 2, 3. So to make sure that all these things are right, what am I trying to say here is that in order to get a perfect picture, you have to put people in the right place so that they can show, they can fulfill the purpose, they can be there, they can feature, they can show. A short man wants to stand the picture, he has to be in front. That's his position. That's his destiny. He has to be in the front. He literally has to be in the front. A tall person has to be at the back. If I want to stand the picture, they will always tell me to go to the back because I'm tall.
You know, we can't shout, we are tall, so we don't have to start, you know. The big job will see us, whether we stand up, we sit down, it will see us, you know. We can't shout. It's the same thing when you go to a corporate office or you go to a firm, you see accountants, you see business people, you see the decision takers, you see the secretary, you see the security, you see the accountant, you see the manager, you see the ask me people. You have people in different departments. So what is this story all about? This story of crossover is just about division of labor. That means that a short person is effectively going to show in a picture in the front. A tall person will effectively show in a picture at the back. When you go to a firm, an accountant will do an accountant's job. An accountant will not come and do a security man's job. A manager will not come and do a cleaner's job. An accountant cannot come and sit in the office of a manager. He's ready to leave his work. In fact, he might not even collect the money for the month. In fact, if the manager is a very wicked person, he might fire him and send him to the police station. So basically, crossovers, what they do is, when you have a full range speaker, those speakers that you've set up and the one you see on the ground, they do different things. They are from two different worlds. So what a crossover does, a crossover says that, okay, you, Mr. Full Range Speaker, this is your limitation. You must not go beyond this. Mr. Subwoofer, this is your range. You must not go between here and here. Mr. Full Range, you cannot go between here and here. So it is now that filter that I explained, that you now determine how much of you want A to slide in into B, or how much of B you want to slide into A, so that they can, so that this is how they, so that if you want them to be like this, or you want them to be like this, or you want them to be like this, or you want them to be like this, it depends on how much of this, how open or how closed the sieve is. So you use that to determine how much of the range of frequency you want the sub to handle, and how much range, what range of frequency you want the full range to handle. Now for the final one, which is the limiter. Limiter is just a divider that says that you are coming like this, you can't go more than this. That is, in fact, if you like be shouting, turn to this, turn to lion, turn to tiger, turn to leopard, turn to elephant, you are not passing this. In fact, you go and look for whatever you want to bring, you are not going anywhere. So what the limiter does is it will tell you that you cannot exceed these points. It helps to control audio from spoiling the amplifier, because at times we have tendencies to over push the amplifier. So once you set a limiter will not allow the amplifier to go above whatever you set it to do. So it's going to create a brick wall. That's the word they use, a brick wall, a wall that cannot be broken, so that no matter how much you put that, it will just duck it like this, just press it down. You ain't going nowhere, bro. So that's what a limiter does. That is what it does, basically. So we come everything I said. All these things, they are inside one processor called the speaker processor, DSP, digital speaker processor. So instead of you buying a limiter processor, an equalizer processor, a crossover, you know, you can buy them in single units, you can buy them individually, but they made it so easy for that you put everything in just one box, and that is all you need. People will use digital consoles to do crossover, but for me, it doesn't work. It doesn't give me that energy. And after it doesn't give me that energy a speaker processor gives me. It doesn't work for me, but there's this energy I get from the low end. If I use the speaker processor, instantly I will hear it. But with a mixer, I have tried it. Maybe I didn't do it well. Maybe you guys can teach me how to do it. I don't mind though. You guys can show me. I would love to. I'm a learner. I love to learn new things. That is why I'm passionate about what I do. I never settle. If I did something, I'm successful at something now, I will always go. The next thing is to challenge myself that this is not right enough. I can do better. This is good. I celebrate it. I don't stick to the celebration. I move. What's the next thing? What's next?
Under the next one.
Something like that. So thank you so much for your time. Thank you for taking time to watch this video. I'm happy that you watch this video to the end. You are going to do great. In fact, people cannot bully you again, because you are already becoming a sound engineer indirectly.
you are beginning to become an audio expert indirectly. This is how you build yourself from one stage to the other. You don't need to know too much, but you can just have an idea. So what I'm bringing to you is an idea so that you can always be able to speak out. You won't say that I don't understand about this. You can always speak out. You can use stuff like this that I use to describe what you're saying to the person. And if the person has, if the person is a knowledgeable person, you know, if it's the person is a professional, if the person is professional enough, you will understand what you mean and just print your idea for you, just like that.
Just like that. So
I want to say thank you. Stay blessed. Don't let Nigeria depress you. Stay happy all the time. Never let a challenge put you down. Wherever you have an issue, just trust in God. I'm a Christian, I'm not a Muslim. You see, I want to go and cut my beard before they start calling me Afa and saying Salam Amaleku. I don't know how they call it. So, one word for you: be good, help people like I'm helping you. I'm not collecting money for this video I'm doing. I want you guys to be educated and I want you to be able to perform better. You know, it's my joy to see people doing the right thing. So thank you very much. Stay blessed.